Hey Alan, thanks for taking a look at this. So I'm just going to show you. In the contacts here, I've set up a test user. So let's take a look at that. And see, I've get the focus. All right, I've put in a name, just some bogus data. So I've put in a mobile number and a business number. So this represents kind of our use case scenario is we have some people and we contact them via mobile and via business, and I've saved that. So that is definitely in our 3CX contacts there. I have also registered this SNOM 870. You see it's running the latest firmware version. It is attached to my extension and it is working really great. So let's go over to the SNOM and go to our directory and go all the way down to our test user. Oops. And let's take a look. And this is the only data that shows up in the test user. We're not seeing the business number. The type is stated as business, which is odd. And we have this birthday here. But for instance, let's take a look at another contact here. Let's just take a look at my, let's see. Let's take a look at this other contact here. Okay. So anyway, this is the problem. The problem is that we're only seeing the mobile number showing up. We're not seeing the business number. So that 11111 bogus number is under the mobile field. We're not seeing the business number. I thought maybe it could only show one number per contact, and so I was gonna make a business contact in a mobile, one with just a mobile number and one with just a business number. But in reality, it's not sending anything other than the mobile number. So what I've had to do is kind of create two contacts for each person. So in the first name, I'm putting their first and last name, for instance, here. In the first name, I'm putting Art Shapiro. The last name, I'm putting mobile. And then I'm putting a different number in for each one. So this is truly the mobile one. And if I go here, I'm labeling again first and last name in the first name, using the last name field for work, and then putting the work number here in mobile. That kind of workaround, it is working, but it's a little inconvenient because it's leading to a lot of additional entries, double or maybe even triple entries here in the directory. And ideally, also with contacts that are internal extensions, for instance, this is my internal extension contact information. You see here, this is my internal extension information. And if I went here to extensions, and you see here under my internal extension 101, I also have my mobile number listed, but it's not coming up here in my internal extension, in the contact for the internal extension. I've had to do the same hack as before and create an entry in 3CX contacts just for my mobile extension. So that's kind of the basis of the issue. Maybe also being able to program this type and birthday stuff could be, nice and secondary. And then the other thing that we're seeing, all this is much smaller. I guess it doesn't matter all that much, but we have this calendar icon here, and when I go, just says no data available. I'm really not sure what data is could go here or where that would be set. That's totally secondary. Kind of doesn't even matter. I'm just trying to work out the directory listings. Also, it seems that this little screensaver automatically goes on after a brief period of inactivity on the phone. I probably wouldn't would prefer to have this BLF virtual keys kind of be the home and not really go to the 3CX logo ever. Like, this would be great if this was just always up, and the default. So anyway, that's it. Thank you for taking the time. If you have any questions, just contact me.